Good morning, this is Kurt Ness with Ness Brothers, and I'm here talking about our 55 plus relocation services, where our goal is through the process of educating people that we can help them create a plan and execute that plan when they're dealing with downsizing or if they have to deal with an estate. And by being educated, again, the goal is to help reduce stress in life. Lord knows that we have enough stress in our life. If you want to watch prior videos and get information on topics that I've talked about in the past, if you go to this website, the 55plusrelocationservices.com, or you can even go to just nessbros.com. and click on services, you will find the link there that will take you to the material that I've talked about in the past and I'm going to be talking about in the future. So I'm going to digress this week and kind of talk about something that took place a couple days ago. And on Wednesday, I attended a seminar down in Indianapolis. And the topic of that seminar was estate administration from start to finish. In fact, they gave me this book. And just to give you a little bit of information that went on at that seminar, there was approximately 50 people that attended. And in this room, this was a program that was put on for continuing education for attorneys, estate attorneys, also paralegals and financial planners and accountants. Ironically, when they went around the room and asked what profession people were in, I was the only one that was not in those professions that I just mentioned. I got a wealth of information from the seminar. There were several speakers. In fact, one of the speakers was Bruce Steer, which is right here in Fort Wayne. He's with the firm of Logan and Steer. And he talked about one section dealing with the estates. But this eight-hour course dealt with everything, and I'm looking at the index while I'm looking down, I apologize, about everything from initial steps to the estate administration process to marshaling assets, that's where finding assets, handling creditors and claims and debt, handling estate administration for tax issues, distribution and closing of the estate, and ethic and estate administration. So a lot of good information, a lot of question and answers. It just gave me a lot of information so that my goal when dealing with individuals is not to know all the information, but to know the people that know the answers to the questions that are posed to me when I'm dealing with people that are thinking about downsizing, or I'm dealing with people that have to deal with mom and dad's estate and questions that they have. And maybe I don't know the answers, but I can at least have enough information to point people in the right direction. The first section was dealing with initial steps to the estate administration process. And the attorney got up and talked, and she was from Indianapolis, and she talked about when she gets that initial call from people and they're just asking questions about maybe a loved one has passed away and like what are the steps that need to be done. And she's actually put together a questionnaire of information that people need to have when they go into that attorney's office, so that the attorney can do the best job possible. A lot of times when I'm sitting down with people and they're talking about downsizing, I kind of use this example that I liken my profession to a doctor. If you were to go into a doctor's office and the doctor didn't ask you a series of questions, didn't check your heart, didn't do blood tests, but instead said, hey, I've got this special in this green pill today, go ahead and take it and come back in 2 weeks and we'll talk then. You'd wonder what type of a doctor they really are. And it deals, that same philosophy carries through when you're talking to an attorney. For an attorney to do the just best job possible, obviously they need to get a clear picture of what the situation is, who are the players, in other words, the family members, where they are located. And I found the questionnaire that they had gone over very helpful. And in fact, if you're interested in that questionnaire, just reach out to me through instant message and I'd be happy to get it to you. I'm planning on next week to go through that questionnaire. But one of the things that I can't emphasize enough is that when you are downsizing, probably one of the most important things is to put all of your financial information, whether it is online accounts, such as an Amazon, and if there's a credit card associated with that Amazon account, to your credit cards, to the pension accounts that you may have, checking accounts, banking accounts, etc., all in one location, and make sure that someone knows where, you can trust, obviously, where that stuff is. One example they talked about and I thought was interesting is an attorney told of the story of having to get into a safe deposit box, couldn't find the key. Do you have any idea how much it costs to get a locksmith to drill out the lock on a safe deposit box? Well, and the price that the attorney told me was about $250. And the ironic thing is that when they opened that safe deposit box, there was only one document in there. And it was a copy of the will, which the attorney actually had. And so there are, again, things that a person can do that can help save money. I'm seeing the clock at 7 minutes. I've gone longer than I wanted to. But in the next couple of weeks, I'm going to go using this book as a reference and go through the different sections of things that I felt were very helpful that can help you when you're thinking about making a transition, downsizing. That, if you haven't done it, is the time to pull things together. Well, again, I thank you for your time. I'm sorry I was late. Had breakfast with a friend. So, Mark, make sure you watch this. I did mention your name. But everybody have a great week, and hopefully we'll get some sunshine.